your filmography, it's obvious that you're interested in the African diaspora. I wanted to know what made you want to go beyond the African American scope.
I think because learning about, okay, I had some formal studies about that. And then I did a master's degree, and I studied the Latin American stuff, something called Latin American Studies.
Então, eu perguntei ao Billy o que fez querer sair do âmbito de African American, afro-americano, para falar desse tema que é presente em toda a sua filmografia, que é a diáspora africana. E então, o que nos está a dizer é que tinha estudos prévios, formais, acerca disso, penso que até pan-africanos, pan-African studies, e também fez formação em Latin American, ou seja, latino-americano, estudos latino-americanos, é uma área de conhecimento.
Maybe to give a short and maybe a more simple answer, the interest in Africa, and even, you know, in its complexity, in its whatever its limitations, the interest in that is a kind of constant for the black people in the United States. It's an old story. We know from the times of, from at least two centuries, they were concerned about that. And then some of the leading thinkers among those people, W.E.B. Du Bois and people like that, the Pan-African idea grew up in the so-called, in the Americas and in the Caribbean, and later in the metropolitan areas of Europe. It didn't start this thing about Pan-Africanism in Africa. It's an idea from those outside.
O interesse por África é uma constante para a comunidade negra nos Estados Unidos há mais de 200 anos. E essa ideia de Pan-África não é algo que tenha sido criado pelos africanos ou em África, é sim uma coisa, um movimento ou um conceito americano, caribenho e depois que também em algumas metrópoles europeias também se engrou de alguma forma.
And it's a part of the culture and the politics and the intellectual life of people, but it's also it's there in other forms because we have the African Methodist Episcopal Church. We have and because we have that, we have since the 19th century missionaries who actually know something about Africa because they went to Africa to proselytize and evangelize for the different denominations, Protestant churches, Methodists and Baptists and different ones.
Sim, igrejas que existem, igrejas nos Estados Unidos, metodistas, batistas, africanas que têm missionários, pessoas que foram efetivamente à África e, portanto, conhecem essa realidade.
And it's a kind of, it's partly an inheritance. Because the time of the African independence after the Second World War coincides with the sort of the civil rights movement. Many of those people studied in the United States. So it's a kind of inheritance. We don't have to be very original and seeking to be somehow fascinated or interested by that.
É uma herança, no fundo não é uma coisa que está presente houve uma época em que coincidiu a emancipação de alguns países em África com o movimento dos direitos civis nos Estados Unidos e, portanto, é natural que essa herança se manifeste.
And I will be hopefully brief about this. What happened was maybe for my generation of people, maybe one of the most important and captivating stories or bit of history was, okay, many African countries achieved independence in 1958 to 1960 in the former British colonies and the former French colonies, to one degree or another. The story of my time maybe is the story of the anti-colonial movement and the liberation movements in what was then Portuguese Africa. So that, because it differed in many aspects from the previous generation, they inherited that, but they were captivating because they proposed a different way, a different approach, and we learned about them, and maybe we had some similar questions.
This previous generation.
Maybe people of my generation, but I know that you can see in the films that some of those people made references to the different liberation movements in former Portuguese Africa. So partly is that it was the time and the awareness and the sense that it was different.
A maior parte das colónias francesas, inglesas e dos países e de outras colónias africanas ganhou independência ou conquistou independência entre 58 e 60 e o caso de Portugal foi diferente e então sempre houve pessoas, havia pessoas a pensar sobre isso e a ter ideias interessantes sobre isso e tanto na geração anterior como na geração do próprio Bélio.
The other thing is, I think, okay, it's an ongoing discussion about colonialism, post-colonialism, and even now decolonize these things. And for me, it's obvious, but I mean other people notice, that most of the discussions about the colonial experience in Africa is about the French and the French and the British example. Very often Portugal goes unmentioned. The experience, just to account for the colonial experience. Germany had its own limited experience, Italy had limited experience, but the Portuguese was more substantial than those two. But it's always the British and French.
Fala-se muito de bom, são temas de colonialismo, anticolonialismo e descolonização, mas foca-se sempre muito os franceses, os ingleses, e Portugal, por algum motivo, fica um bocado fora dessa discussão, apesar de ter tido uma experiência mais substancial, bastante mais substancial a esse respeito do que países como Alemanha ou Itália. The idea for this film that you're presenting here today came up while you were doing research for this documentary about Mário Pinto de Andrade, the Angolan intellectual and activist. Do you want to tell us about that process, like when you find this photograph by chance and decide to do a movie about what's behind it?
I was in the Museum of Resistance and Liberation in Lisbon, and I saw a version, I saw a large, enlarged version of the first photograph you see in the film.
Fazer uma pesquisa no Museu do Aljube, encontrei uma foto, uma versão grande da primeira foto que se vê no filme.
I saw the one photograph, I thought I could make something with it. It was so captivating that I thought I could make something with it. I started to do some preliminary attempts with that, and then I learned that there was, it was not a single photograph, it was a larger collection of photographs.
E a foto era super cativante, e então Billy achou que podia fazer alguma coisa com ela e começou a fazer algumas tentativas preliminares, e depois percebeu que aquilo era só a ponta do iceberg, não era só uma foto, havia muitas mais.
I was working with an editor, Luis Nunez, that I worked with to finish the Kaufman film, and after the film, maybe one day after finishing everything, I had these photographs that had been found in the archive of the National Maritime Museum. And I proposed to him that maybe let's see if we can do something with them, because they didn't fit into the longer film. He was interested, and he's a wonderful editor, but he's also a wonderful kind of and very helpful to me in composing the idea, you know? So we did that film, which is only 13 minutes, but that film suggested to me that I could do something.
But that's another
yeah,
that
that's
we don't
film I
know
made
about.
Before, right after
Kaufman. Oh, okay.
No, Marseille après la guerre.
Oh, the Marseille après la guerre. Billy trabalha com um montador, o Luís Nunes, certo? Que o ajuda muito no processo, e com ele, o Billy comentou que tinha umas fotos de um arquivo marítimo, e pensaram que... O Billy pensou que se podia fazer alguma coisa a partir daquilo, falou com o Luís disse que sim, e então o resultado foi o filme anterior a este, o Marseille après la guerre.
And because of that experience, maybe, and also working a lot with photographs in the Kaufman film, I thought I could do something with it, and that's where it began, and then eventually we were able to realize something, finish something.
Right. Depois do filme, o Kaufman film é o filme And When I Die, I Won't Stay Dead, que é um filme sobre o poeta Bob Kaufman. E é um filme em que também há muito trabalho com fotografias. E, portanto, depois de fazer muito trabalho com fotografias no filme sobre o Kaufman e de fazer este filme, o Marseille après la guerre, Billy pensou que podia fazer mais alguma coisa sobre isso, e é daí que vem estes três filmes com fotografias. Okay.
I just want to say thank you so much to the Cine Club of Visio for inviting me to participate. It's wonderful to be here. I'm glad to have seen some very wonderful films. And I'm sorry I leave tomorrow, but hopefully I'll see you again.
Hopefully, yes. Thank you very much.